Hey guys, this is Azizullah Muradi from MCCAS Consultancy and Coaching YouTube channel. You are watching the part 4 of the video on how to make computer run faster.
MCCAS, transforming experience, presenting opportunities.
Tip number 13. Uninstall unused programs or uninstall non-essential apps. Uninstalling unused or unwanted programs can help your computer in various ways. By uninstalling these programs, you will be adding hard drive space, increasing computer speed. Apps won't have access to run in the background anymore, which results in PC speeds. Enhancing your computer security in EDC. So now, how to uninstall a program? Let's do it practically. You simply go to search bar, type control panel. On the top results, select control panel, click on programs. In this window, there is a list of the programs you have installed in your computer, and you can choose any of them and uninstall them. So what the program that I'm gonna uninstall is Torch. You either right click on it, you choose uninstall, or you can select and go up there, click on uninstall or change, put a check mark on the box, click on uninstall. You flash the page, and now you will see the program is gone, it is uninstalled. Tip number 14, use Total PC Cleaner. What is Total PC Cleaner? Total PC Cleaner is a free disk space cleanup tool which optimizes memory in Windows system, boosts productivity by clearing out your PC's cache and junk files. It scans your whole computer to clean up unnecessary files, speeds up your PC, and boosts its performance. So, how to use Total PC Cleaner? To get Total PC Cleaner, you go to search bar and type Microsoft Store. Click on top results, Microsoft Store. Click on search, type Total PC Cleaner. Click on this. Click on install. Here it shows this product is installed. Click on launch. Maximize. Please confirm your system disk. To authorize normal functions, click continue and then select system disk in the next window. Continue. Scroll down and choose C drive. Select. Here it asks you upgrade to Total PC Cleaner Pro. You should never do it, just close it. We need only the Total PC Cleaner. So here if you see, there is a button start scan. Click on start scan. So it takes time. I'll be back. Here you see the Total PC Cleaner is scanned for the system caches. Application caches is 0, mail cache is 0, that's why we cannot put a check mark here. Office caches, browser caches, and downloads, we have some downloads. If you want to delete the downloads, the applications that you recently downloaded, if you want to delete them, just put a check mark and click on clean. So it takes time. I'll be back. It is done now. Just click on done. Here click on close and click on escape. Click on close. Tip number 15. Do not clean up browsing data. Guys, you might have heard that cleaning the browsing data speeds up your computer, but it is not true. Previously, we have deleted browsing data by the Total PC Cleaner. There is an option for deleting browsing caches here. If we delete the browsing caches with Total PC Cleaner, it is okay. because it only deletes some of the very unnecessary caches. It is okay to use the Total PC Cleaner for deleting browser caches, but deleting from the browser is not recommended. Why shouldn't you delete the browsing data? Cleaning up browsing data clears your cache, which will slow down your web browsing while your browser rebuilds the caches. In other words, when you visit a web page, your browser has to download all the resources that the web page requires. This includes images, style sheets, JavaScript files, and anything else on the page. The cache is a place where your browser stores copies of these files, so it doesn't have to download them again the next time you visit a page that requires them. In result, it helps reduce loading time of the web pages. When do you need to clean up browsing data? Clean up browsing data if you don't want anyone else to see what web pages you have visited. But if it is your personal computer and no one has access to it, leave the browsing data alone. If you still want to delete the browsing data, but probably don't, let me show you how to delete it. Open any browser you want to delete the browsing data. This is the Chrome browser. On the right up there, click on three dots, select Settings. Scroll down. Here you are, clear browsing data. Click on this. In this small window, you have two options, basic and advanced. Click on advanced. Select all of them. I do not select this one because if it clears up the password, so that is I do not want. Yeah, click on clear data. It takes 1 to 2 minutes. So when you see this kind of a small pop-up, just click on OK. You're done. Tip number 16, empty the recycle bin. It helps to free up more space. How often should you empty the recycle bin? Emptying the recycle bin permanently deletes files from your hard drive. It is recommended to empty the recycle bin only when you are sure you don't need the files again. Now, how to empty the recycle bin? On your desktop, on the left, there is an icon of recycle bin. Right-click on recycle bin and choose empty recycle bin. Click on yes, continue. You're done. Tip number 17. Fix low disk space error due to a full temp folder. You might have seen the errors like low disk space, you're running out of disk space on local disk C or D or F or any other drive. Click here to see if you can see free space on this drive, Windows Explorer. Or you can see like this, low disk space, you're running out of space on this PC. Manage storage to view usage and free up some space. Don't remind me again here, manage storage or close. While you use disk cleanup to free up space on your device and then see a low disk space error. It is possible that your temp folder is quickly filling up with application files that are used by Microsoft Store. To fix this problem, you will need to number 1. Reset Microsoft Store. How we do it? Go to Start, Settings, Update and Security. On the left pane, click on Troubleshoot. Scroll down. Click on Windows Store Apps. On its bottom, click on Run the Troubleshooter. We do this action to find any error might have been occurred on the Windows Store apps. Here in my computer, it says user account control has been turned off. So I want to enable it because it is useful for the computer. User account control has been disabled, so this is fixed now. Close. Okay, till now we are done with the finding errors on Windows stored apps. Now let's go to reset it. Once you are done here, you go back and tap on apps, scroll down here, Microsoft Store. Click on this and click on advanced options. Scroll down. Here you see an option, reset. If this app isn't working right, reset it. The app's data will be deleted. We are going to click on reset. This will permanently delete the app's data on this device, including your preferences and sign-in details. Reset. So there is now a tick mark. We have done it. Reset it. Next is clear the Microsoft Store cache. To clear the Microsoft Store cache, you go to search, type run, enter, write wsreset.exe, enter. Once you do it, a blank command prompt window will open like this, and after some seconds the window will close and the store will open automatically. Then we will be done with the clearing the Microsoft Store cache. You see Microsoft Store is now opening. It is opened. We close it. The next step is run Windows Update Troubleshooter. How we do it? You go to Start, Setting, Update and Security, Troubleshoot. Scroll down here, click on Windows Update and you will see run the troubleshooter. Click on run the troubleshooter. Windows Update troubleshooting couldn't identify the problem. If there is any problem regarding the Windows updates, there will be showing here. So nothing is in my computer, I just click on close. And the last step is reboot your computer and see if you're still experiencing the issue. Okay guys, we are done with the part 4 of the video. We will continue it to the next video, part 5. Part 5 of this video will be coming soon. Bye and good luck.